हॅलो एव्हरीवन, मायसेल्फ मनोज पाटील, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर इन सिव्हिल इंजिनिअरिंग डिपार्टमेंट MUPS KBT CUE नाशिक. डिअर स्टुडंट, टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट रेन वॉटर हार्वेस्टिंग. सी, इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट दी व्हॉट इज मीन बाय रेन वॉटर हार्वेस्टिंग, व्हाय देर इज नेसेसिटी ऑफ रेन वॉटर हार्वेस्टिंग, then the benefits of that rainwater harvesting, methods of rainwater harvesting, then we are discuss about the components of rainwater harvesting system, then the advantages and disadvantages of rainwater harvesting, and lastly precaution to be taken for the rainwater harvesting system. See, water is the most essential fuel of life. Clean and safe water for daily use is the basic need of human being. Even after decades of hard work and struggle by the government bodies and other organizations to supply ample amount of potable water to each and every human being in every corner of the world is still not achieved. Today, though we might say that we are moving in a jet age, but still in remote places where there is civilization, people have to walk several kilometers in search of water to quench their thirst. So to cater this need, rainwater harvesting is the best option. See, rainwater harvesting system is there from prehistoric period. Okay, see, this is the simple technology. In African countries, placing a small container under the eaves of the roof to collect the falling water during the storm, and which saves a walk of several kilometers. See, in developed countries, sophisticated rainwater systems have been developed with the aim of reducing water bill and to meet the needs of remote communities in arid regions where the water is scarce. So, see student, what is meant by rainwater harvesting? See, this rainwater harvesting system, it is the process of collection of rainwater from surfaces on which rain is fall and filtering it and storing it for multiple uses. See, rainwater harvesting technology is used for collecting and storing rainwater for human use. Okay, and that rainwater from the rooftops or from the land surface or from the rock catchment. See, it is the activity of direct collection of rainwater, and rainwater can be stored for direct use or can be recharged into the groundwater aquifer. See, keeping in the mind the Indian climatic condition, we get the rainfall for only 60 days, okay, out of the 365 days on an average, okay, and in the region which have heavy rainfall, we can collect and store this rainwater falling over the terrace or roof, which otherwise goes to the sea through the rivers. See, rainwater is the purest form of water, and it is the primary source of water, and other sources are dependent on the rainwater. Hence, the rainwater harvesting system is the revolution required to be implemented for this jet age. Okay, so everyone should look forward for the rainwater harvesting system with a positive attitude, because life without water is as true as body without soul. That's why this rainwater harvesting system is very, very important and necessary. See, in our Maharashtra, there are two good examples where this rainwater system is properly utilized. There are two places in our Maharashtra, Rayagan Siddhi and Hivrey Bazar, where these rainwater harvesting systems are properly implemented, and that people, the villages, that people who are living in that villages, they are having lot of benefits of that rainwater harvesting system. Okay. Now see, what are the different benefits of this rainwater harvesting system? First, the ample water throughout the season. See, sufficient quantity of water is available throughout the season, isn't it? Or throughout the year. Then this rainwater harvesting system increases the groundwater table. This is very great benefit of this rainwater harvesting system. Then this rainwater harvesting system reduces the water bill. It can be used every society and class of people as per their need. So people can use that rainwater, harvested water, as per their need. Okay. This rainwater system is very simple technique for the construction also. Then this rainwater harvesting, it is the comparatively pure and safe water. Okay. This rainwater harvesting system reduces the erosion of soil. It also avoids the floody roads. So these are the various benefits of the rainwater harvesting. See, it also reduces the intrusion of seawater in groundwater also. So these are the various benefits of rainwater harvesting system. Now see, what are the methods of rainwater harvesting system? See, there are mainly two types of methods are there which we have to be utilized for the rainwater harvesting system. First one is the storage of rainwater and its use, and second one is the recharging the underground aquifer by rainwater and using it as when it is required. So see, first one, storage of rainwater and its use. See, in this method, what happened? See, in storage of rainwater, a rainwater harvesting system, it is consist of four basic elements. First one is the a collection area. Okay, see, in this figure, this is the collection area. Then the conveyance system. These are the diffusion pipe. These are the conveyance system. Then the filtration system. Okay, here is the filter unit is provided. Filtration system and storage facility. Okay, these four basic elements are involved in the storage of rainwater harvesting system. Okay, so see, the collection area in most cases is the roof. Okay, see here, the collection area in most cases is the roof or the terrace of the building, and the effective roof area and the material of roof or terrace influence the efficiency of collection. A conveyance system usually consists of gutters and pipe. Okay, see, these are the conveyance system, and normally for the collection of this pipes or water, we are using the CI or PVC pipe, AC pipe or GI pipe for conveyance through the mechanical filter to the storage tank. For the storage of this rainwater, okay, we are using the tanks of which are to be made up of RCC or bricks, ferrocrete, okay, that tank we are to be used for store that water. So this is about the storage of rainwater system. Now second one is the recharging the underground aquifer by rainwater. This is the second method of rainwater harvesting. See, the main purpose of artificial aquifer recharge technology is to store the excess water for later use. Okay, there are several artificial techniques including the infiltration basin, canals, water traps, okay, then cut water, surface runoff, drainage well, okay, then through the dug well, bore well, and diversion of excess from irrigation canal into sinkhole. Okay, see, this artificial recharge has been used in many countries. Okay, in areas where groundwater is an important component of the water supply and rainfall variability, it does not allow a sufficient level of aquifer recharge by natural means. Okay, so this technology is provided for the artificial enhancement of the groundwater storage. Okay, so the storage of surface runoff in underground aquifer in arid and semi-arid region has the advantages of minimizing evaporation losses. See, when there is a heavy rain, the harvested rainwater cannot be accommodated in rainwater harvesting compartment then there will be a overflow out of rainwater harvesting component, isn't it? So this excess water can use to recharge the underground water table. So this is the second recharging the underground aquifer method. Now see, there are various systems or there are components which are to be used in the rainwater harvesting system, like roof catchment, gutter, downpipe and first flushing pipe, filter unit and storage tank. Okay, these are the components of the rainwater harvesting system. First one is the roof catchment. See, as shown in this figure, this is the roof catchment. See, the roof of the house is used as a catchment for collecting the rainwater. What are the roof area is there? We have to utilize this roof area for the catchment purpose of the rainwater. Okay, and the style, construction and material of the roof affects its suitability and the catchment. Okay, the roof which is to be made up of corrugated iron sheet or asbestos sheet, tiles or concrete can be utilized for that rainwater harvesting, isn't it? So this is about the roof catchment. Then second component is the gutter. Okay, see, what is the use of gutter? See, gutters are channels which are to be fixed to the edge of the roof here. Okay, all around the collect and transport the rainwater from the roof. So these gutters, see here, these gutters are utilized for the collection and transportation of the rainwater. Okay, see, these gutters are made up of in semi or circular and rectangular shape with cement pipe or plain galvanized iron sheet or PVC pipe. Okay, see, to reduce the cost of this making this gutter, we can use the locally available material also. So the main function of that gutter is what? To collect and transport that rainwater to the filter unit. Next one is the downpipe. This is the next component. See, here is this downpipe shown in this figure. So what is the downpipe? So it is the pipe which carries the rainwater from the gutters to the filter and to the storage tank. Okay, see, this downpipe is joined with this gutter at one end, and the other end is connected to this filter unit of the storage tank. See, PVC or GI pipe of 50 mm to 75 mm are commonly used for the downpipe or 2 inch pipe. Okay, see, bamboo can also be used wherever available and possible. Now next one is the, see, this is the first flush pipe. See, what happened during the first rain? Debris, dust and dirt collect on the roof during the non-rainy period or when the first rain arrive. Okay, a first flush system arrangement is made up to avoid the entering the unwanted material into the filter media and storage tank. Otherwise, what happened? That will disturb the efficiency of that filtration. So for that purpose, this first flush pipe is to be provided. See, this is a simple manually operated arrangement or semi-automatic system with a wall below the T-junction. So what happened? The first rain pipe is allowed to pass through the first flush pipe. It is not stored in the storage tank. Okay, so for that purpose, this first flush pipe is to be provided. Next one is the filter unit. See, this is a very important. See, the filter unit is a container or chamber filled with water media such as coarse sand, charcoal, coconut fiber, pebble and gravel for removal of the debris and dirt from the water that enters in the tank. So for that purpose, see here in this figure, filter unit is to be provided. See, this filter unit is provided above the storage tank, or it is provided separately. Okay, see, it may be of ferro cement filter unit or aluminium or cement rings or plastic bucket, isn't it? So this is about the filter unit. And lastly, storage tank. Okay, so see, here is the storage tank. See, storage tank is used to store the water that is collected from the roof through the filter. So for small scale water storage is plastic buckets, clay or cement jar, ceramic jar, drum may be used. Okay, or for large scale, a rectangular or circular storage tank which are to be made up of the PCC or RCC, okay, that tanks are used. See, the storage tank is provided with the cover on the top to avoid the contamination of water from the external source. Now see, structure for the artificial recharge of the water. See, there are two types of structure which are to be utilized for the artificial recharge. First, there are two type, main type, shallow structure and deep structure. That shallow structure again divided into two parts. That is, first one is the recharge pit, second one is the recharge shaft. And second main type of the artificial recharge is the deep structure, which are again divided into two parts, bore well and dug well. Now we have to discuss one by one in detail. See, first one is the recharge pit. See, this recharge pit is having the length of 1 to 2 meter, or sometimes it is having the size length 2 to 3 meter, okay, and width is 1 to 2 meter and depth is varies from 2 to 3 meter. See, this recharge pit should have 0.3 meter raised portion above the ground so as to protect the entry of unsettled runoff over the ground, isn't it? See, that recharge pit should be filled with the rubbles, okay, and pebbles over the pebble 0.3 meters of sand, okay, that should be laid. In recharge pit, there should be a freeboard of 0.5 meter above the sand level. Okay, see, there should be as far as possible minimum silt content in the water to be discharged for the recharging purpose. See, this recharge pit is useful for the area of 100 to 150 square meter of catchment area, and for that recharge pit, periodic cleaning is very necessary. See, for more area of catchment, more number of pits should be constructed. Now, second type of shallow structure is the recharge shaft. See, this recharge shafts are the circular shaft bore into the ground, which is filled with the filter material. So, see, these are the filter materials, small sand, okay, small boulder, big boulders. So, recharge shaft is the circular shaft bore into the ground which is filled with the filter materials. See, the diameter of the recharge shaft is around 1 meter and the depth of the recharge shaft is in between 2 to 3 meter. See, the layers of filter material and freeboards are the same as in recharge pit. This recharge shaft should be covered, and this recharge shaft are useful for the 100 square meter of the catchment area. For this recharge pit, periodic cleaning is necessary. Okay, see, for more area of catchment, more shaft should be constructed. Now, second type of artificial recharge is the deep structure. See, first one is type of the deep structure is the bore well. See, terrace or rooftop rainwater, either from the design on line rainwater filter or through gravity filter, shall be discharged into the bore well. Okay, see, there are various features of recharging the rainwater into the bore well. See, first one is the one vein pipe should be provided on the upper side of the bore well. Okay, then overflow rate should be provided to bore well to discharge the rainwater when it is saturated, okay, so not to cause any overflow. Then if the groundwater runoff is to be harvested, it will first have to flow through gravity filter and then it will be recharged through the bore well, because whenever it flow through the gravity filter, what if the impurities are in that water that are to be trapped and removed. Then for this bore well, periodic cleaning and maintenance is required. Okay, then acceptance capacity of the bore well, it is depend upon the geological condition of the ground. This is the one of the main feature of the recharging rainwater into borewell. Okay, and this borewell, this method is most suitable for those borewell which were giving good yield in the past but are now in dry condition. For more catchment area, number of borewell should be increased. Now we have talk about the deep structure, that is dug well. See, what is dug well? If the well is present near the building, okay, and the artificial recharging can be done by discharging water into the well through online filter or gravity filter. Okay, see, if the ground runoff is to be discharged, it should be passed through settling tank before filtration. So for that system, this dug well system, periodic cleaning is necessary, isn't it? Now, advantages of the rainwater harvesting system. What are the different advantages of the rainwater harvesting system? See, first one is the rainwater harvesting system provide water at or near the point where the water is needed or used. Second one is the rainwater is relatively clean and the quality is usually acceptable for many purposes with little or even no treatment. So this is the second advantage of rainwater harvesting system. Then this rainwater harvesting system is independent and therefore suitable for the scattered settlement. Okay, then local material and craftsmanship can be used in the construction of this rainwater system. So it is very simple to construct the rainwater harvesting. So local material we can utilize for the construction of the rainwater harvesting system. Okay, then it is easy to maintain. Okay, and lastly, it provides a water supply buffer for use in times of emergency or breakdown of the public water supply system. So we can utilize this rainwater harvested rainwater at any time. Okay, so these are some advantages or benefits of the rainwater harvesting system. Now, what are the limitations of the rainwater harvesting system? See, first one is the initial cost, mainly for the construction of the storage tank, okay, is more. Okay, the initial cost may be prevent a family from installing a rainwater system. Then the water availability is limited by the rainfall intensity and the available roof area. So these are the two factors, rainfall intensity and available roof area, affect the quantity of rainwater harvesting. Okay, then mineral free rainwater has a flat stage, okay, which may not be liked by many. Okay, and the poor segment of the population may not have a roofs suitable for rainwater harvesting. Okay, so these are the some limitation of the rainwater harvesting system. Now last thing of this chapter, this lecture, is the precaution to be taken for the rainwater harvesting. See, whenever we are doing the rainwater harvesting, so what precautions are required to be taken for the rainwater harvesting system? See, first one is the no wastewater pipeline should be connected to the rainwater pipe. Okay, so what are the wastewater pipes are there that should not connect to the rainwater harvesting pipe? Okay, then the quality material should be used for the rainwater harvesting. Okay, what are the material which we have to be utilized for making rainwater harvesting system? That should be quality material, because sometimes we utilize that water for the potable purpose, for drinking purpose or other purposes. So quality material you should utilize whenever you have to construct or made that rainwater harvesting system. Then third precaution, do not keep any waste material on the terrace, because the main catchment area of the rainwater harvesting system is what? Terrace or roof area. So you should not keep any waste material on that terrace, otherwise what happens? That waste material is mixed with that rainwater, okay, and it is harmful to us. Then Terrace should be clean before the monsoon. This is the very important precaution. Because if terrace is not clean, whatever the dirty material which are to be placed on that terrace, okay, that will be harvested. That will be flow through that rainwater, and that will be stored in that rainwater harvesting system. Okay, and which will be harmful to the human body. Then next precaution is the you should jali, screen or net should be provided at the beginning of rainwater pipe at the terrace. So to avoid the entry of that floating matter, debris. So for that purpose, you should provide the jali or screen or net at the beginning of the rainwater pipe. Then periodic cleaning of filter and settlement tank is required. This is also very important. Then the repair and maintenance of the tanks, filter is necessary. Then in case of rainwater is required for potable purpose, the care should be taken to disinfect properly. It is also very important. If you have to utilize that harvested rainwater for the potable purpose, so first of all you have to disinfect it by using various disinfectant. Okay. Then filter media should be cleaned thoroughly after every 3 years. Okay. What are the filter media which we have to utilize? That should be clean after every 3 years. And lastly, wash out the first rainwater. This is also very important, because in first rainwater, so there whatever the impurities that are to be present on the terrace also or in rainwater. So first of all, you have to wash out the first rain. Okay. And backwashing should be carried out whenever necessary. So these are the various precautions which you have to be taken whenever you are doing the rainwater harvesting system. So thank you, student. I hope that all of you understand about the rainwater harvesting system. What is meant by rainwater harvesting? Why it is necessary? What are the benefits of rainwater harvesting system? What are the methods of rainwater harvesting system? Then the components of rainwater harvesting system. Okay, then the advantages, disadvantages, and the precaution to be taken during the rainwater harvesting system. Dear student, in this topic, in this regard, if you have any difficulty, any question, you can ask me frankly. Thank you so much.